think people can raise their hands.
One question has come, how to diagnose and connect it to the physical organs? See, the chakras are there outside the physical body. Each chakra has got control over certain physical organs. So when a person talks about our ailment, we know where the problem is. So we just go to the particular chakra, when you heal the particular chakra, automatically the healing takes place. So from the negative energy is removed, positive energy goes through the particular chakra, goes to the organs under the control of that particular chakra. So physical body, so for your information, any stress in the mind initially causes problem in the auric body, then the chakra. Physical body is the last one to react. So it's as long as the negative energy is the auric body and chakra, mind place. Mind can be healed by going to the auric body chakra. Physical body, when it shows the symptom, you have to cleanse the auric body chakra. The chakras are, each chakra has got control over certain physical organs. So you, by the way the person talks, you know which physical organs are showing the symptom. So we remove the negative energy in all the chakras, bring harmony among the seven chakras. By healing, then automatically the energy goes to the physical organs also, healing takes place. The energy, cosmic energy knows what to do, where to go, how to act. Cosmic energy is the divine energy created by the Supreme Soul. When we show our hand, the cosmic energy goes through our palm, to the palm chakra, to the particular chakra, goes to the physical body, where the root cause is there. So once the energy goes to the root cause, not only the root cause is removed, the symptom also gets removed.
There is one more question, ma'am, from Kritika. If we do for many persons at a time or only one at a time, whether effect will, effect wise difference will be there?
What is one at a time, the group means? What do you mean by that?
She is asking mass healing and single, the difference between them.
Mass healing, yes, heals. We just call this as magnified healing. We bring the energy to all the people. Assembling, yes, it is possible. Group healing we are doing. One at a time, because if the person wants individual healing, you can do it. Mass healing we are doing, especially when you just assemble during on the full moon day. At that time, we do mass healing. It is also effective.
From Praveen, is it possible to increase the height of a person irrespective of age limit?
Pardon?
Is it possible to increase the height of a person irrespective of age limit?
No, no. See, height actually is related to the age. See, children are the age of 4 or 5, you just say kulla madarka. But yes. Yes, at the stage of puberty, suddenly the person becomes tall. So up to that time only you can do something for height. But beyond that, for girls up to the age of 14, 15, you can do that. For the boys up to the age of 16, 17, because brain is growing, spinal cord is growing, you can just do the stretching by going to the chakra, going through the chakras. After that, it is not possible. But they can go for yoga, I do not know. Up to the age of puberty, they can do for height, not after that.
The general question from all the participants, is there any online classes to learn, ma'am?
Online classes are taken by all the masters who were there for to present at the papers. Online courses are only, online courses only are there because of the lockdown. Only, see, after that I was taking direct classes. And once the lockdown came, actually my life came to a standstill. I did not know what to do. Then I thought Reiki should be kept alive. So with that intention, I got the permission from my angels, Dr. Mika Oshi. Then I started conducting classes, online courses. I have trained the masters also to do online courses. All of them are doing online courses now. Those who are presented papers, some more of them are there. All of them are doing.
For a family protection, can we do it singly or group? That is the question from yes, ma'am, Harish. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, why don't you answer?
Yes, ma'am. people
will also grandmaster.
Yes, ma'am. People would wanted to hear it from you, ma'am. That's why.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
For family protection, can we give individually one by one or any other solution?
You're not answering.
How? Oh, myself. Okay. Symbols of Reiki has been used for the family protection. The and also individually, if you wanted, like you need to, as ma'am said, aura cleansing has to be done if it is done individually. And then while doing the Reiki meditation, we can gain the power of Reiki in all the chakras so as to harmonize all the chakras. And with the golden ball meditation, we can protect ourselves too. Over to you, ma'am, for the additional solution that they have asked.
Family means you are living in a home. Home itself can be protected from the negative energy. In second degree, we are teaching how to cleanse the negative energy from home, how to energize the home with the positive energy. That can be done. Or just family protection. You are in a family, in the house, the family is in the same, all of you are in the same house. You can protect yourself, you can protect the house itself.
For my mother, Gajalakshmi, for my mother, leg, knee, swelling, and doctor told backside bone is weak. So please tell me which chakra for her. From child, my mother suffered more. Okay. So your question is, the legs and the knees part is swelling and the backside bone is weak. These two are the questions from Gajalakshmi, ma'am. Mooladhara chakra has to be strengthened. When you said it is mother, I hope she is a senior citizen. So for every human being, Mooladhara chakra has to be strengthened for their strengthening of the life. So that is one. And with regard to leg and knee, Swadhisthana chakra has to be connected, which is the next chakra that has a connection. So all the respective symbol has to be applied on the Mooladhara chakra and Swadhisthana chakra. The entire back chakras has to be strengthened as well for the strengthening of the backside bone. I hope you are mentioning the lumbosacral bone. That is definitely Mooladhara chakra. When you connect with the back entire chakras, the strengthening will be obtained so that the leg pain will be removed off. With regard to the knee swelling or the local area itself, we can apply Reiki with the help of the symbols. Thank you. Ma'am, would you like to add on to it?
No, it's okay. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. There is one unique question. I did Western Reiki, Jiki Den Reiki, both two levels. How do I go about it?
Western Reiki and?
Jiki Den Reiki.
Oh, Western Reiki, I don't know whether they are teaching everything about chakras and the connection, the link between the chakras and endocrine glands. If they are teaching, well and good, because See, even chakras names are all Sanskrit. Sanskrit names are there. They say they use ordinary English words. Sahasrara chakra, head chakra. Agni chakra, forehead chakra. Vishuddha chakra, throat chakra, like that. So they are converting it to English, and I do not know whether they are connecting the chakra with the internal organs. What they are teaching, I have no idea. But only thing is, they are simplifying the whole thing. One person actually says he is a grandmaster. One Western person from West, one person came to India. He said, so simple, you just keep your hand like this. He didn't teach, only 5 minutes he took. One foreigner came to India, he came to Chennai. He just told, you just keep your hand here. You have the energy, you keep your hand here, 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 you are healed. You are a master. He has given a certificate as a master. So this is the sense. Everything is simplified, but we do not know whether it is true or not. But only thing is, but there are very good masters in Western country, in USA. They are teaching very nicely. I have no doubt about it. But there are some masters who are just coming, they are just telling, do this, and then go away, collect money and go away. But I have got lot of people in America. They are doing wonderful work. And they are teaching. They have got their own association. I like that. The way they teach, we do not know. We have to find out.
He has asked about Jikiden Reiki also. Jikiden. Yes. Jikiden Reiki.
I don't know what it is.
Okay.
You don't know? Do you know?
No, ma'am. I am not aware of that. So we will get back to you after that on your question. The next common question which has arisen here is the difference between Reiki and pranic healing. Here in Reiki, the attunement process is there, which is very, very sacred and secret. Whereas in pranic healing, the attunement process is not there. And in Reiki, the modality is safe and secure. Whereas in pranic healing, the safety depends upon the auric level, wherein we have to be more precautious and safe. Over to Dr. Ma'am for the addition of points.
In pranic healing, see, I told you already that anybody can learn Reiki. Illiterate people also can Reiki. When an illiterate person has got no knowledge about maths or science or anything like that, when he goes for pranic healing, he says, you imagine a circle with, supposing you have got pain. You imagine a circle in the center, white light, peripherally 10% blue light. What does he know about the circle? What does he about the 10%? What does he know about the cell center filled, getting filled with white light? So he says, don't touch this chakra. We just go to the back manipura chakra. They are not supposed to, we are not chronic healing, they are not supposed to. They say, Ming chakra, don't touch this chakra at all. So there are certain limitations are there. Here, we touch any part of the body for healing. There are some restrictions in pranic healing. So they say for some area, you should not use orange color at all. So you have to use orange color only. Some for some, you should not use orange color. So white light, 10%, if it is infectious, 10% blue light, 10% green light, whether the person does not know whether infectious or not. So all these things are there. He has to use the brain. Here in Reiki, we are not using our brain at all. We are not using our brain. God has given us brain. He is expecting us to elicit the information, get the information from the patient. That's all. But the rest of the things done by the Sahasrara chakra and Agni chakra. We are not using the brain at all. In pranic healing, you have to use your brain. Whether this particular chakra is blue color or red color or violet color, all these things are there. As you said, attunement is not there. Attunement makes the person a good healer.
Thank you, ma'am, for the wonderful explanation. There is one more question. How can we change a person's perspective about Reiki when it is your own family member? This is from Pratipa Saravanan. Yes, ma'am. You please continue, ma'am.
Go ahead.
First, when it is our own family member, I think it is on the psychological aspect and the emotional level. One, when we are a Reiki channel, we are saying that we are filled with unconditional love. So Reiki is inside itself, it gives us a transformation of the perspective within us, number one. Number two, there is a symbol which can be applied at their Agni Chakra and that will change their own perspective if you are a Reiki healer in your family. Number three, the way we are seeing at the person constantly, if our mind is clogged with one particular aspect, we will be framed with same set of mindset when we are viewing others. This is in general. So on Reiki, I said two things. One on the emotional level, we have to be enhance ourselves with the power of Reiki and the unconditional love and the application of symbol towards the Agni Chakra and the Manipura Chakra. Over to you, ma'am, for the next, additional point.
The family, husband and wife. Husband doesn't believe what wife does. Take as Reiki healing. For such persons, you don't have to force. Reiki should not be forced on anybody. So, you don't have to claim. When he is sleeping, you do Reiki. Because Reiki is only done with love. You are not doing black magic. You are not doing anything else to harm the person. You want him to believe Reiki. So, when he is sleeping, you can do Reiki. So, only he will recover. If the person doesn't believe, to make him believe, to do Reiki when he is sleeping, vice versa.
There's one last.
To make the person you believe in the family.
Okay.
Yes. I think you can.
Yeah, ma'am. Last question. My mother is at the age of 80 years old. She urinates frequently only during night. Do we have a solution for that in Reiki? And she is a diabetic too. So for urination, Swadhisthana Chakra, as you have mentioned the year very clearly, 80 years, for the strengthening, Muladhara Chakra, for the strengthening of the lifespan. Secondly, to the on the urination part, Swadhisthana Chakra, front and back. And regarding the diabetic, Manipura Chakra. So the root cause definitely would have been a worry when it comes to diabetic. And also the insecurity that she is holding on to might be in the age of 80 years old. So when we do Reiki, Reiki itself connects to the energy factor, where it has to work, what it has to do. It heals the root cause and the symptom of the ailment. So it is the energy factor that works in and through her, which makes the complete healing possible. Thank you. With Dr. P.S. ma'am's permission, there is three participant was raised their hand. Could we go ahead with that or should we go with the guided meditation, ma'am?
It is for you to decide.
Okay, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
You have to go to the Agni Chakra because Agni Chakra thinks of it actually has got the fear. It's night, whether I'm going to urinate during night, I have to get up for urination, etc. So mind has to be free from stress. So Agni, not only that, Agni Chakra has got control over all the other chakras, including Swadhisthana and Muladhara. So you have to energize Agni Chakra, Swadhisthana and Muladhara.
Okay.